What's up guys, it's Hashir Tihami back again with another tutorial. In this one we are going to discover how we can create components and their variants, and we are going to develop a huge library of components where we can see what is the best practice to create components and why do we need the variants. So in front of me right now we have the design library of AntDesign, and it's a massive library that you can also find over the internet. I'm gonna drop the link in the description below. This file helped me as an individual to develop my components and variants knowledge. It starts with buttons, icons, typography, and everything that is sorted out as a component. Now, in the basics series, I am going to explain the need of atomic design system, where we are going to see the effect that one atom can make to create a whole page. So for this one, let's just stick to the components first. Okay, so here right now you can see there's a huge library of buttons, and if I drag one of them out, you can see that here we have all the properties defined with property names and this toggle button that can include or hide the icon behind the text. So we are going to develop all these. So let's begin. Okay, so let's start with a button first. I'm going to make an auto layout component here with 24 pixels on either sides, give it a 4 radius and give it a fill. I think that's good enough to start with. Okay, so why do we need a component? So the basic need of component is that when you have to change or make alteration in your design, you won't have to go through all of those screens that the component exists in. You would just have to go back to your component, make the changes, which will be applied on all of the instances that component exists in. So let's start with making a little component here. So to create a component, you just have to press this button, or you can just remember the shortcut key for that. I would recommend to remember the shortcut key because it is really efficient to use your keyboard while doing this stuff. So I'm going to press Alt Control K, and that component is created. So I'm going to name it button. Alright, so what is an instance? So if I drag that one out and place it right over here, this specific button is an instance of the main component right over here. So if I make any changes in this one, these changes won't be reflected in this specific button right here, which is the main component. But if I change the color in this component, you can see that all the instances that are present are going to behave the same way as that component is. So if I have to change the text here, you can see that all the instances are going to reflect that change as well. So that's the basic need to define a component. Now, what is a variant? A variant can be defined as a subset of that component that doesn't necessarily exist same as that component. Okay, so what does that mean? So let's say we have two types of buttons. One button has just text and the other one has an icon as well. So for that, I'm just going to grab an icon. Now, to create a variant, I would have to just click on the main component and press this button right over here, which would add a new variant to this library. Now you can see these dotted lines suggest that these two are variant of one single button. What does that mean? So let's see. If I copy this icon and paste it in here, you can see that it just adjusted because it was made on auto layout. Again, if you want to see how an auto layout component is made, I have a whole series on that, which I'm still working on, but for the basics, you can always refer to that series. Okay, so I need this button to be defined as a text only button, and I want this one to be defined as a button with an icon. So to do that, I have to define the property. The easiest way would be to select the layer of that variant and then edit it. Now I'm going to define it icon equal to yes, sorry, no, because there is no icon in there. And then copy it, go to the next variant and paste it here. But in this one, we are going to type yes. Now, if I pull one out, you can see that we have a cute little toggle here. If I press the toggle on, the icon would appear. and that same toggle can be used to disappear that icon. So what Figma is doing here, it is switching between those two variants that you had just defined in the main component. And if you change the position of that icon in the main component, that change will reflect in all of the instances that you have created using the same component. So let's say if I have to change the position of this icon to the right side, you will see that if I now toggle this instance, the icon would be present on the right side, just as defined in the main component itself. Easy peasy, eh? So that's the basic understanding of how to create a component and how to make a variant. Now there is another way of defining a set of components, and we are going to see that one too. So let's grab them out and detach them from the main component because we can't make any change in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Ctrl+Alt+B. See how this icon right next to the button indicates that this is an instance of the main component. This rhombus with an outline shows that it's just an instance of the main component, and the main component always has this icon. Okay, so when I press Ctrl+Alt+B, you can see that that icon is gone and that purple outline is also gone. So that means button right here is not an instance of that main component anymore. And I'm going to do the same with this one too. Again, if you don't remember the shortcut key, you would have to just right click on that instance and go to Detach Instance here. And the shortcut key is written right over here. So if you ever forget the shortcut key, you would have to just right click on it and find it yourself. Alright, so I have detached these two buttons from the main component. Now I am going to select both of them, and now you can see that there is a drop down icon with a component icon. So when I press this, you can see we have create component, we have create multiple components, and then we have create component set. If I press create multiple components, what it will do, it will create two different components and not a set like this. But we don't need that. We need one component set with two variants in it. So I'm going to press this, and you can see that we have made a similar component set as this one. And if I want to add a new variant in it, I would just press this plus button and maybe change the location, or you know, make a different button right here. But right now, for sake of this tutorial, let's not. Now by default, you can see that both of these properties are defined as property, and the name of these variants is defined as default. So I would have to do the same thing as I did here. I would just go to default and rename it icon no, and in this one icon yes. And you can see that it is going to do the same thing that we had done here. Now there are three different ways to create this toggle effect. Right now I am using the yes and no approach, where the property name equal to yes and property name equal to no. But you can also do that using yes, no, on, off, or true or false. So what does that mean? So if I go over here and press icon false, and in this one icon true, you can see that the variant will still have the same effect as we were using with yes and no combination. And same goes for on and off as well. So that was a quick tutorial on how to create a component and a toggle variant. In the next one, we are going to introduce some new properties on one button, because in this one, you can see if I grab one component out of here, this instance has five different properties, and each individual property can be accessed using this specific section. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. Make sure you subscribe the channel so you don't miss the next tutorial that is coming up for a larger design system development. And yeah, see you later, alligator. Bye.